Yes, this is going to be another one of those videos. Some quick tips that will help you edit faster in Final Cut Pro. Let's get it. If you want to add volume to your audio, all you need to do is to use the compressor effect. So find it in the effects tab and double click to apply it to your audio. I usually use this for my talking heads audio. Listen to the difference.
But there is actually an easier way to do the very same thing. But there is actually an easier way to do the very same thing.
I hope you guys can hear the difference because it also made my volume a little bit more uniform. Now I know this effect is a very powerful effect and it can do more than increasing your volume, but that's gonna be a tutorial for another video. Another audio effect you should definitely use is the limiter effect. And guess what? With this effect, you can, wait for it, limit the decibel of your audio to whatever you like. For talking heads, I usually don't go over -3 dB. I actually stay around -6 dB, but -3 dB is fine. So go to the audio inspector tab and you can slide this to -3 dB. Or you can just type it. Now you won't have any sudden loud pitch in your video. Okay, enough with the audio tips. Let's talk video really quick. If you shot a B-roll and you want to import only the video on the timeline, you can just press Shift 2 or click here and choose video only. Then you can select the video or the range you want to use. To select the range, you can skim through the video and use the range tool. Press I for an in point and O for an out point. And there's your range. Press Q and it will be added on top of your storyline as a connected clip. So the A roll is on the main storyline and the B roll is a connected clip. If you're planning to import other medias with both audio and video, just remember to put these back to all or press Shift 1 because we changed it and it's gonna stay there unless you change it back. But let's say you don't like the range of the B roll that you picked. The cool thing is you don't have to delete this one and redo the process all over again. Like try to find what you like and import it into the timeline. You can just use the trim tool to do what they call a roll trim. Yeah, and to do that, press T, or if you like the longer route, go here and choose the trim tool. You see the mouse pointer changed. Now you can click on the B-roll video and drag, roll it until you find the part you want to keep. You can also look at the viewer window to see where you are in this footage. When you find what you like, just release the mouse. And the best part is the length of this video. Check this out. The placement of this B-roll did not change. Of course, roll trimming only works with the available media that you have, and it will stop when you reach the far ends of the clip. You see when the edges turn red? That means that there's no more media that you can use on that side. But I really like this method because it's a non-destructive method. That's it. If you guys got any value from these quick tips, subscribe and go check out these tips for Final Cut Pro users. And I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.